In the beginning, the Word gave origin to the Father, a Witoto creation myth.
A phantasm. Nothing else existed in the beginning. The Father touched an illusion. He grasped something mysterious. Nothing existed. Through the agency of a dream, our Father, Nai Muena, kept the mirage to his body. And he pondered long and thought deeply. Nothing existed, not even a stick to support the vision. Our Father attached the illusion to the thread of a dream and kept it by the aid of his breath. He sounded to reach the bottom of the appearance, but there was nothing. Nothing existed, indeed. Then the Father again investigated the bottom of the mystery. He tied the empty illusion to the dream thread and pressed the magical substance upon it. Then by the aid of his dream, he held it like a wisp of raw cotton. Then he seized the mirage bottom and stamped upon it repeatedly, sitting down at last on his dreamed earth. The earth phantasm was his now, and he spat out saliva repeatedly so that the forests might grow. Then he lay down on his earth and covered it with the roof of heaven. As he was the owner of the earth, he placed above it the blue and the white sky. Thereupon Rafuema, the man who has the narrative, sitting at the base of the sky, pondered, and he created this story so that we might listen to it here upon earth.
A creation account from the Chandogya Upanishad. In the beginning, this was non-existent. It became existent. It grew. It turned into an egg. The egg lay for the time of a year. The egg broke open. The two eggs were one of silver, the other of gold. The silver one became this earth, the golden one the sky, the thick membrane of the white, the mountains, the thin membrane of the yolk, the mist with the clouds, the small veins, the rivers, the fluid, the sea. And what was born from it, that was Brahman, the sun. When he was born, shouts of hurrah arose, and all beings arose, and all things which they desired. Therefore, whenever the sun rises and sets, shouts of hurrah arise, and all beings arise, and all things which they desire.
From God's account of the creation in the Book of Enoch. And I commanded in the very lowest that visible things should come from invisible. And Adoel came down very great, and I beheld, and look, it was a belly of great light. And I said, spread apart, and let the visible come out of thee. And it spread apart, and a great light came. And I was in the center of the light, and as light is born from light, an age came out, a great age. And it showed me all the creation I had thought to make. And I saw that it was good. And I set a throne up for myself, and took my seat on it. And I said to the light, go up higher and fix yourself high above the throne and be a foundation for the highest things. And above the light there is nothing else. And then I leaned back and I looked up from my throne. And I commanded the lowest a second time. And I said, let Ahas come forth hard. And it came forth hard from the invisible. And it came forth hard, heavy, and very red. And I said, be opened, Ahas, and let there be born from thee. And it became open, an age came out, a very great, a very dark age, bearing the creation of all lower things. And I saw that it was good, and said, go down below, and make yourself firm, and be a foundation for the lower things. And it happened, and it went down and fixed itself, and became the foundation for the lower things. And below the darkness there is nothing else.
A Maori poem on the creation of light. From the conception, the increase. From the increase, the swelling. From the swelling, the thought. From the thought, the remembrance. From the remembrance, the desire.
The word became fruitful. It dwelt with the feeble glimmering. It brought forth night, the great night, the long night, the lowest night, the highest night, the thick night to be felt, the night to be touched, the night unseen, the night following on, the night ending in death.
From the nothing, the begetting, from the nothing, the increase, from the nothing, the abundance, the power of increasing, the living breath. It dwelt with the empty space. It produced the atmosphere which is above us.
The atmosphere which floats above the earth, The great firmament above us, the spread-out space dwelt with the early dawn. Then the moon sprang forth. The atmosphere above dwelt with the glowing sky. Then the sun sprang forth. They were thrown up above as the chief eyes of heaven. Then the sky became light, the early dawn, the early day, the midday, the blaze of day from the sky.